हेलो लर्नर्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल श्रद्धास फिजिक्स। हियर वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर लेक्चर विद द सॉलिड स्टेट फिजिक्स। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी द ज्योमेट्रिकल स्ट्रक्चर फैक्टर, दैट इज द ज्योमेट्रिकल स्ट्रक्चर फैक्टर ऑफ द क्रिस्टल। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक विद द ज्योमेट्रिकल स्ट्रक्चर फैक्टर। सो वी हैव सीन दैट इन ए क्रिस्टल लैटिस द पॉसिबल रिफ्लेक्शंस आर डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय द रेसिप्रोकल लैटिस पॉइंट, एंड दिस रेसिप्रोकल लैटिस आर बेसिकली द परपेंडिकुलर टू द रियल लैटिस। And we calculate this reciprocal lattice in the Miller planes or the Miller indices, you can say. So for that, this position vector or this total reciprocal vector, we represent this as this G vector, that is equal to H A plus K B vector plus L C vector. This capital A, capital B and capital C, these are basically the lattice parameter in case of the reciprocal lattice. And this HKL, they are basically represents the Miller planes, okay, or the Miller indices. Now, you can see here, this G vector is represented HA plus KB plus LC vector. This one is capital A, capital B and capital C, since we are considering for the reciprocal vector. So, the intensity of the beam scattered from a crystal, it depends on this intensity of the beam for the crystal. It depends on the atomic scattering factor of the atom, that is the number of atoms present in a crystal. It depends the intensity of the scattering and the number of atoms in the unit cell, atomic scattering factor of the atom, the type of atoms in the unit cell and the distribution of the atom in the unit cell. So the intensity of the beam that is scattered from a crystal, it will depends on these four quantities. So if more atoms are present in the cell as in the actual case, so the phase differences of the scattered wave from the different atoms, it must be taken into consideration. So for the characteristic of the intensity of the particular order reflection and the relative intensities of the various reflection which are permitted by the Bragg's law, we consider the contributions made by the atoms in the unit cell to the contribution made to the scattered amplitude in a given direction. So this is done by calculating the factor, that is FHKL, for a given reflection, that is HKL, which is called the geometrical or crystal structure factor, that is this FHKL is a pure number. So basically we can say that this geometrical structure factor, this is suppose S, it can be written as, it is the ratio between the amplitude scattered by the entire FHKL unit cell divided by the amplitude scattered by a point electron at the origin for the same incident beam. Okay, for the same incident beam, the total scattering amplitude for the entire unit cell to the amplitude scattered by a point electron at the origin for the same incident beam. Okay, so the basis which forms a group of atoms attached to the lattice point is repeated in space to the form a crystal structure. We know when a crystal structure is to be formed, we attach the lattice with it. When a basis attached to a lattice point, then a crystal structure is formed. Bases are basically, it can be atoms or molecules or ions. So when these bases get attached with this lattice point, then a complete crystal structure is formed. Okay. So the number of atoms in a basis, it may be few in many metals and inert gases, but can be less in some elements. Now let Uj, Vj and Wj, they represent the coordinate of the suppose jth atom. Okay, if Uj, Vj and Wj, they represent the coordinates of the jth atom, then we can write this Rj will be equal to this position vector, we can say. So this will be equal to Uja plus Vjb plus Wj into C, and this is just small a, small b and small c, because here this Rj represents the in the real space, or this is the A, B, C are the lattice parameter in the real space. Now if I'll write Rj vector dot n, then this will be simply lambda Ujh plus Vjk plus Wjl, because you know the reciprocal lattice is simply perpendicular to the real space lattice. So the total scattering amplitude for the unit cell, we can write FHKL will be equal to sum over j Fj exponential I phi j, and also we know this phi is the phase difference, and phase difference is nothing but fj exponential. This will be, in place of phi we will write, this is your 2 pi by lambda into the path difference. Here the path difference is rj dot n. Since we have already discussed it in the atomic scattering factor, so we are not going to the further details in that. So simply this is your phi value is I into, this will be 2 pi by lambda into rj dot n. So phi is the phase, okay, and this summation, it extends over all the atoms belonging to a inner cell. This fj is the atomic scattering factor. This small fj, it is the atomic scattering factor for the jth atom. And phi j is the phase difference between the radiation scattered from the jth atom of the inner cell and that scattered from the electron placed at the origin. So this is the phase difference. And simply, rj is the vector position, that is the position vector of the jth atom, and n is the normal scattering. Now, if I put this value rj dot n in this equation 3, that is fj exponential I 2 pi by lambda into, this will be lambda ujh plus vjk plus wjl, then you can see here this lambda will get cancelled with this lambda, then this will be simply 2 pi I into this much. Now you can see this expression, that is fhkl will be equal to sum over j fj exponential I into 2 pi, that is 2 pi I ujh plus vjk plus wjl. This is suppose equation 4. But for the identical atoms, all the fj's have the same value, that is f, that is the atomic scattering factor is same. If there are identical atoms, then the atomic scattering factor or the form factor will be remain same. So here we can write this fhkl equal to f into s. So s will be equal to here this exponential 2 pi I ujh plus vjk plus wjl. So this one is the most important relation you can see here. This s value, that is the geometrical structure factor, this equal to exponential 2 pi I ujh plus vjk plus wjl, that is j represents for the jth atom, and this hkl is the Miller indices, hkl are the Miller indices. So this geometrical structure factor is, it depends on the geometrical arrangement of the atoms within the unit cell, okay, which is the limitations of the Bragg's law. But here in case of the geometrical structure factor, it depends on the geometrical arrangement of the atoms in the inner cell. Now though, what is the physical significance of this S? There is no intensity at reflection N allowed by the space lattice corresponding to S equal to 0. And the missing reflection, it helps us to determine the structure of the lattice of the crystal, and the geometrical structure factor, it may not be real. So you can say that now the intensity of the diffracted beam is proportional to the square of the amplitude f, or you can simply write it as I will be equal to f square, or this is equal to f into f star, where f star represents the complex conjugate of this f. Now if I write the value of f is here, you can see fj exponential I 2 pi ujh plus vjk plus wjl. So if I'll take the complex conjugate of this, then this will be simply exponential minus 2 pi I. So here let me write, so if I'll, here you can see it, this will be, intensity will be equal to sum over, this will be fj cos 2 pi ujh plus vjk plus wjl plus I sin 2 pi ujh plus vjk plus wjl into, this will be, you can see here, let me write this expression. If you write for the f, this will be exponential 2 pi I ujh plus vjk plus wjl, okay. So here you can see, if I split this exponential term, you know, exponential I theta is cos theta plus I sin theta. So now here, this will be cos 2 pi into this much term, that is this bracketed term, plus iota sin pi, sin 2 pi, this bracketed term. And similarly, for this f star, simply I have to put a negative sign here. So this will be, you know, exponential minus I theta equal to cos theta minus I sin theta. So here in this case also, cos 2 pi into this much minus I sin 2 pi into this much. ओके नाउ दिस इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए प्लस आई बी इंटू ए माइनस आई बी. सो दिस इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए प्लस आई बी इंटू ए माइनस आई बी. सो दिस विल बी सिंपली ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर बिकॉज यू नो ए प्लस आई बी इफ आई लेट ए प्लस आई बी इंटू ए माइनस आई बी. सो सिंपली दिस विल बी ए स्क्वेयर माइनस आई बी होल स्क्वेयर. आई स्क्वेयर इज माइनस वन एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो माइनस सो दिस विल बिकम प्लस. सो दिस विल बी ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर. ओके नाउ हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज एफ जे कॉस टू पाई यू जे एस प्लस बी जे के प्लस डब्ल्यू जे एल होल स्क्वेयर प्लस दिस विल बी एफ जे साइन टू पाई यू जे एच प्लस बी जे के प्लस डब्ल्यू जे एल होल स्क्वेयर. दिस इज द इंटेंसिटी. सो द स्कैटरिंग इंटेंसिटी इट वैनिशेस इन ऑल डिरेक्शन एक्सेप्ट दोज इन विच द स्ट्रक्चर फैक्टर एस इज नॉन वैनिशिंग. सो दिस लेटर डिरेक्शन एट द डिरेक्शन ऑफ द डिफ्रैक्शन. सो वेन द ब्रैग कंडीशन इज सैटिस्फाइड देन द इंसिडेंट बीम इज डिफ्रैक्टेड इन टू ए सिंगल बीम विच इज रिकॉर्डेड एट द डिटेक्टर एज ए सिंगल स्पॉट ऑन ए फिल्म एंड दिस स्पॉट इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द होल सेट ऑफ रिफ्लेक्टिंग प्लेन दैट इज एच के एल वेन द क्रिस्टल इज रोटेटेड सो दैट ए न्यू सेट ऑफ प्लेन्स अगेन सैटिस्फाइज द ब्रैग कंडीशन देन द न्यू सेट अपियर्स एज ए न्यू स्पॉट ऑन द फिल्म ऑफ द डिटेक्टर. ओके सो हियर ईच स्पॉट ऑन द फिल्म इट रिप्रेजेंट्स ए होल सेट ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइन प्लेन्स एंड फ्रॉम द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ दिस स्पॉट्स वन कैन डिटर्मिन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द क्रिस्टल. सो नाउ लेट अस सी फॉर द सिंपल क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल. सो इन द सिंपल क्यूबिक क्रिस्टल यू नो यू जे इक्वल टू वी जे इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू जे इक्वल टू जीरो व्हेन इट इज एट द ओरिजिन. नाउ इफ यू विल पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ एच के एल दैट इज यू नो एफ एच के एल वैल्यू इज स्मॉल एफ इन टू एक्सपोनेंशियल टू पाई आई यू जे एच प्लस वी जे के प्लस डब्ल्यू जे एल व्हेन इट इज डब्ल्यू जे एल. ओके सो व्हेन यू वी डब्ल्यू दिस आर यू जीरो दैट इज व्हेन यू विल कंसिडर दिस यूनिट सेल इज एट द ओरिजिन. सो फॉर दैट केस दिस विल बी simply f equal to f. Hence all the lines predicted by the Bragg's law it will occur it provided f is sufficiently large to make the peaks or the peaks of intensity is visible. Okay now similarly for the BCC crystal you can see there are two identical atoms per unit cell and one that is for one contributed by the corner atoms and the other that is totally lies inside their cell or the center of the cell. So let uj equal to bj equal to wj that is equal to 0 for the corner atoms. And the other atom in the cell is the body centered atom which belongs to the unit cell and its coordinates are suppose 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. So now if I write the geometrical structure factor then this will be s equal to f into this will be summation over exponential 2 pi I huj plus kbj plus l into wj. Now if I'll put for the first for the corner atom you know here we have considered this for the corner atom uj vj and wj that is equal to 0. So this total term equal to 0 that is exponential 0 plus for the body centered atom this is exponential I 2 pi h by 2 plus k by 2 plus this will be l by 2. Now this can be written as s will be equal to f into 1 plus exponential I pi that is this 2 will get cancelled with this 1 by 2 term if I will take common then this will be exponential I pi into h plus k plus a that is for the BCC crystal the geometrical structure factor is f into 1 plus exponential I pi h plus k plus l. Okay now again h plus k plus l. Now for any reflection HKL for which this H plus K plus L if I will add this and it is an odd integer then this exponential I pi H plus K plus L that will be equal to minus 1 because we have already discussed in our complex part that is the mathematical pages. When this exponential I pi into some odd term is present here so then its value will be equal to minus 1 and if this h plus k plus l this value is your even integer then that value will be plus 1. So for odd, this value is minus 1, and for even, this value will be plus 1. Now here you can see that this a is equal to f into 1 plus this much, and when this is odd, you can see this will be 1 plus minus of 1, or simply this is 1 minus 1, and its value goes to 0. So here you can see that the geometrical structure factor will be 0 when this h plus k plus l equal to odd integer. And similarly, when it is even, that is plus 1, then this will be simply 2f. When h plus k plus l is even, then its value will be geometrical structure factor, or this capital F value, this will be simply 2f. This value is 2f. So for the first order reflection, for BCC structure, it doesn't take place for the planes like 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, etc. Because you can see here, if you will add this 1, 0, 0, this will be 1 plus 0 plus 0, then this is simply 1, which is an odd integer. For this odd integer, the value of f, or we can say that this geometrical structure factor, simply if I write this value is s, and its value is 0, when it is a odd integer, since its value is minus 1, this exponential term value, this total value goes to minus 1 when this h plus k plus l is odd, then this geometrical structure factor goes to 0. So here you will get no BCC structure. So here you will not get any BCC structure. Similarly, if you will add a 1, 1, 1, then this is again 3. This is also your odd one. And simply 2 plus 2 plus 1, that is also 5. It is also 1. So for this plane, that is 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, when this HKL plane, this 1, 0, 0 means HKL. Okay, this is also for 1, 1, 1, this is also HKL. H value is 1, K value is 1, and L value is 1. Okay, when the value of HKL, HK and L, these are odd, and if we'll add this term, that is when you will add H plus K plus L, if this is odd, then there will be no geometrical structure. But if you will add this H plus K plus L and you will get an even number, then this, for this planes, we can say that BCC structure, for this BCC structure, since the reflection takes place when the reflection will occur at this spot, then you can see that structure, that particular structure, when this term is odd, then you will not get any BCC structure. Or if we will get this H plus K plus L, it is even number, then we will get a BCC structure. Okay. Now similarly for the FCC structure, that is face-centered cubic, you know, for the one contributed by the corner atoms, that is here we are considering the number of atoms per unit cell. So the number of atoms per unit cell is 1 for the corner atoms, and there are 3 atoms because of the face-centered atom. So because of the face-centered atom, the number of atoms per unit cell will be 3. So there are total 4 atoms are present, that is the number of atoms per unit cell is 4. So for the corner atoms, if you will consider, they are at the origin. So for 1, this is 0, 0, 0. For the second atom, if I will consider 0, half, half. And for the next one, this will be suppose 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2. And for the last one, this will be 1 by 2, 1 by 2 and 0. You can see that this is for your face-centered atom and this is for your corner atoms. Okay. Now we will calculate the geometrical structure factor. So this will be simply F HKL will be equal to F into, you can see the value is, let me write the formula first. This is exponential I pi, this is small f, geometrical structure factor equal to Fj, sum over j, exponential I pi uj h plus vjk plus wjl. Since here there are 4 atoms, so we will write for this summation sign, if I will remove this summation sign, I will write 4 terms. That is for the first one, I will write, if I will put this 0, 0, 0, that is 0, 0, 0 in place of u, v, w. So this is the value of u, v and w. If I will put 0, 0, 0, then this term goes to exponential 0. So the for the first one, this will be 1 again. Plus this will be, if I will put the value is uj is 0 for this one, then this will be 0 plus 1 by 2k plus this will be 1, this is 2 pi I, okay, this is 2 pi I, so this will be 1 by 2k plus this will be 1 by 2l, so if we'll take common 1 by 2, then this 2 will get cancelled with this 2, so this will simply k plus l, so you can see here, this expression is exponential I pi k plus n. Similarly, if we'll put 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 here, and this 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 here, then this will be h by 2 plus l by 2. Or if we'll take common 1 by 2, then this 2 will get cancelled with that half. Then this will be simply exponential I pi h plus l. And if we'll put this value 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 0, that is u, v, w value here, then this will be 1 by 2 h, that is h by 2 plus k by 2. If we'll take common 2, then this will be exponential I pi h plus k. Okay, so this is our final expression for the FCC structure. Okay, let me drop this one. So this is the geometrical structure factor. So now, for all even or for all odd indices, that is h, that is individually here we are considering h, k, l, the amplitude f h k l will be equal to 4f, and this is equal to 0 for all odd even combination of h, k, l. That is, here you can see that when the individual h, k, l, it may be even, or that is the total will be even or the total will be odd, then in that case this will be 4f, or if odd or even, for all odd and even combination of h, k, l, this value goes to 0. And we can say that the intensity will be proportional to 4f square, that is 16f square. So the intensity is 0 if one of the indices is even and the other two are odd, then f h k l is 0, so the intensity is also 0. It means that suppose in case of h k l, or we can say that suppose this is for your u v w, so here the h k l plane, in h k l plane, that is in this reciprocal plane, if one of the indices is even, that is if suppose in between this h k l, if any one of it is even and other two are odd, if any of these two is odd, then this value will be equal to 0, that is the intensity is 0. So FCC structure, so in an FCC structure, no reflection can take place for which the integer are partly even and partly odd. So the reflection, so for the reflection, it should be wholly even and totally odd. That is, all the HKL, it should be even, or the total HKL, it should be odd. So this is all for today. Just try to solve some questions on this. Thank you all.